So welcome to this video, which is going to look at the new fluid solver that's embedded inside Vellum, which is one of the exciting new developments in Houdini 19. So I've got here a very simple setup. I've got a tank and I've got a sort of bit of cliff polygonal geometry here, and I'm going to set up a basic fluid simulation. And what we need to start with is a box, which is or any other geometry, which we're going to fill with particles that are going to be our initial fluid. And the important thing here is you'll notice that I've not got that initial fluid box overlapping with any of the other geometry. If you start off with it overlapping, you're going to get the simulation will run out of control pretty quickly. So we now need to configure our initial fluid, and I do that by laying down a Vellum configure fluid node. And we can see that that is just a Vellum grain node, configure grain node, with the type set to fluid. And because I've got quite a large scale here, I'm going to increase my particle size so it simulates quickly. And what are the controls you have here? Well, of course, you have mass and density as usual. The ones that are specific to fluids are phase, which we'll come onto later, and viscosity and surface tension, which I'm also going to leave unchecked for the moment. So, of course, the reason that it's filling our box with these points is because we've got create points from volume enabled here at the top. If you had your own collection of points coming in here, you'll want to disable that. So the next thing to do is lay down a Vellum solver, like so. As you recall, it's got three inputs: the geometry, the constraint network, and collision geometry. Let's get rid of the last because we're going to feed that in separately. And over here we've got some cliff geometry and we've got a tank. Let's merge them together and we're going to put them into the final input here. And this is simple polygonal geometry. That's what Vellum works on. It's going to collide the fluid with the polygons. Let's put the display flag on there and hit play. And we can see that we get a fluid simulation. So now that we've set up basic simulation, let's talk a little bit about what you might want to use Vellum fluids for. Well, start off, they are not a replacement for flip fluids, which are the other fluid solver that's in Houdini. Flip fluids are still going to be better where you have a large tank simulation, ocean, things like that. It's pretty good at simulating viscosity and surface tension. However, if you get really thick fluids, you're better off using flip. And the two things that really stand out as advantages of Vellum fluids is the interaction with other Vellum simulations and the fact that there is a GPU-based solver, which we will come on to in a minute. But before we do that, let's have a look at how you might influence this fluid using forces. And to do that, you've got to dive down inside the Vellum solver. Let me stick this to wire. And you've got two inputs here, source, which we'll look at later, and force. And I'm going to stick down, a pop axis force and connect it. And let me move it across here to about there. Let's increase the radius a little bit and the height a little bit. And let us give it a bit of lift, like so. And now we should find that our fluid, let's get back to that display, now has a force here pushing the fluid up, as you can see. So in order to get the liquid to flow continuously from this sphere, we need to dive down inside the Vellum solver, and we can see we've got a source connector here. And we need to lay down a Vellum source node, connect it up, and then point the sop path at our geometry, the geometry null that we laid down above. And then we need to point the constraint sop path to our constraints, like so. And the other thing we need to do is change the emission type up here. And at the moment, it's only going to emit once right at the beginning. We, of course, want it either to emit on each frame or more. Commonly, you want to emit on each sub-step. So let's change it to that. We go up, press play, we can see that it's now emitting. We don't, however, want to connect these two into the Vellum solver, because otherwise we're doubling up. We would be getting our initial sphere of liquid falling down, and it would also be emitting liquid. So let's get rid of those. I'm pressing Control, I'm pressing the Y key, and then cutting through those. So a couple of other refinements. First of all, if we go down into here into the Vellum source, at the moment the activation is set to 1 throughout, so it's going to emit at every single frame. If you want to limit it to a frame range, you can either animate this, or you can put in an expression. I'm going to put in $S. $F is less than 50. And as you can see, that now got this. That now turns green. And if we go up here, the other thing that you can see perhaps is that these particles at the top here are just staying stationary. That's not realistic. And the way we need to fix that is to go into our Vellum Fluid node, and here when it gets to the seed, we need to have a different seed at each subset or each frame to jitter those differently at each frame. And the easiest way to do that is just to type in here $t. That evaluates to the current time. And as we should now be able to see, those points there are going to jitter around. So this will play through until we get to frame 50 and then stop. So that is the end of the first video on the new Vellum fluids, and I'm going to look in a second video at some of the more advanced features. Thanks very much.